Today, you and me, we join our faith together to break the yoke of poverty in your life. Remember, 1 John chapter 3, verse 8 says, "Victory over poverty is already yours. Through his death on the cross and resurrection, Jesus has destroyed all the works of the devil. But today, I pray to the Lord to enforce that victory by declaring his promises over your life." In 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 3 to 4, Apostle Paul wrote that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Through the truth of God's word, you have been given dominion over financial lack and every other stronghold in your life. Therefore, the enemy knows he has no power, he has no right to harass you. Satan's lies is defeated in your life. In John 8, verse 44, the scripture tells us that the devil is the father of lies. I claim 3 John chapter 1, verse 2 on you. God has replaced lie with the truth. The Lord shall prosper you, and you shall be in good health. I claim Genesis 31, verse 41 to 42 on you. God has seen your affliction and the labor of your hands. You shall not labor in vain. You shall overcome poverty. In John chapter 10, verse 10, Jesus taught us that the devil is a thief who comes to steal and destroy God's blessings in our life. You are a child of God. The devil has no right in your life. But today, by the name above all the names, Jesus Christ, I am moving into an offensive position and will take back for you anything the enemies have stolen from you. Today, I speak boldly to your circumstances, reminding them that you are a child of the King and a joint heir with Christ. My words will create realities, line up with God's word. The Almighty God shall break the yoke of poverty from your life, because poverty is a yoke of the devil. It is not from God at all. God does good things, and there's nothing good in poverty. Therefore, you will be favored by God. You will no longer continue to labor in vain. I claim 3 John chapter 2 on you. Peter worked so hard throughout the night and caught nothing. He became successful. When Jesus met him, released favor on his life. The Lord has visited you today, and he shall release favor into your life. For I know God's supply is limitless. I claim Philippians chapter 19, verse 4 on you. God will supply all your need. I know better we serve a great big God. He's able to equip his children, and he will supply every of their need. For you are a child of God. I pray you will never lack God's supplies. In Jesus' name. 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 9 says, "For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, that you through his poverty might become rich. I decree and declare the richness of God shall be upon your life and your family." I claim Deuteronomy 28, verse 6 on you. It says, "You will be blessed when you come in and be blessed when you go out. Therefore, the richness of God shall be upon your life, all your business and employment of life, whether within doors or without, in the administration of every office, whether public or private, and in all your journeys, going out and coming home, all shall be attended with success. No evil shall fall on your family or dwelling in your absence. When you go out, thy way shall be made prosperous before thee, and thou shalt have the divine blessing in all thy labors at home and abroad in peace." I claim Psalm chapter 23, verse 6 on you. "Surely goodness and mercy shall follow you in all the days of your life. You shall have a confluence of all, both inward and outward, comfort and contentment." I claim Proverbs chapter 10, verse 22 on you. It says, "The blessing of the Lord maketh rich, and he addeth no sorrow with it." God shall bless you with his material wealth, both in silver and gold. God's blessings shall give you simple enjoyment, and the Lord will not levy tax upon the comfort. I claim Psalm chapter 69, verse 33, Psalm chapter 72, verse 12, Psalm chapter 113, verse 7 to 8 on you. God will listen to you, for the Lord hears the poor, and he will deliver the needy when he cries, the poor and the person who has no helper, as he did to Mephibosheth, who found favor from God. In the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 9, verse 8, King David sent for Mephibosheth, who was the crippled son of Jonathan. He told him, "You shall eat at my table, and I will restore to you, Mephibosheth, all the land that belonged to King Saul, your grandfather." Therefore, even if you have been living in seemingly hopeless circumstances, and even if you consider yourself utterly useless like Mephibosheth, who asks King David in 2 Samuel chapter 9, verse 8, "What is your servant that you should show kindness to such a dead dog as I? I pray God will raise you from the oblivion of poverty to the prominence of being seated with princes. God shall change your financial situation. Even if you are crippled physically, educationally, or materially, like he did for Mephibosheth, who could not help himself acquire his grandfather's real estate since he was a lame man." I claim Psalm chapter 12 verse 5 on you. God will turn your poverty to riches, because God can change purpose from poverty to prosperity. And he also reassures us that for the oppression of the poor, for the signing of the needy, "Now I will arise, says the Lord. I will set him in the safety for which he yearns." So I pray to God to give you financial freedom that you yearn. I claim Proverbs chapter 19 verse 4, Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 12 on you. The Lord will open the heavens, bless your handwork, and help you to prosper. Since it is written that the soul of the diligent shall be made rich, you will be debt free in Jesus' name. I claim Psalm chapter 106 verse 4 to 5 on you. God will remember you with his favor and visit you with his salvation, so that you may see the benefit of your chosen ones. Rejoice in the gladness of the nation and glory with his inheritance. I claim Psalm chapter 34 verse 9 to 10, Psalm chapter 84 verse 11, Proverbs chapter 10 verse 24, Psalm chapter 107 verse 24 on you. You will not lack anything, God. The Lord shall bless you. Father Lord, we thank you to have granted our request. May your name be continually praised. In Jesus' name we prayed. Amen.